Welcome to Candid Africa, truthful and unapologetic.
You have to have a commitment to the government. You see it in Japan, it is that commitment of the government of Japan to development. Even now, there are developed countries, but there is a tremendous commitment by the state. Don't listen to this nonsense that the state should give up the direction of the economy. It's nonsensical. And we have so many stupid leaders who think you can develop your country. Somehow you can hand over the development of your country to something called private enterprise, unregulated. Unregulated. Nachiatmas. My name is Nachiatmas. Who had done it? The Japanese have not done it, the British have not done it, the Germans have not done it. They'll be meeting in Halifax in June, they'll be meeting in Halifax. What for? To drink tea? What do you think they're going to meet to do in Halifax? The big seven are going to meet in Halifax. To do what? To discuss how to control the economy. It's not a meeting of bankers, it's a meeting of presidents and prime ministers on the economy. And this ignorant people in Africa being deceived, you know, leave it to the private sector. Where is the private sector? Where is the private sector intervening to which you are going to leave during this development? Where is it? It needs nothing. It needs nothing before you can have it. So you're nursing. This is what the Asian countries have done. And they go on nursing it. So the Japanese did it. Korea. And now they are beginning to open up their market. How do you open up your market to big competitors when you have no power to compete with big competitors? This is ridiculous. I mean, it's like, madam, I'm sorry. You know, in the world of boxing, in the world of boxing, there are heavyweights, middleweights, flyweights, and although the rules are the same, you put them separately, in separate rings. The heavyweights in their own ring, you see? The middleweights in their own ring, you don't put in the same ring. A heavyweight and a featherweight. Never! Never! How do you do that? That is murder, it can't be called. But that's what the big seven are telling us to do. That Germany and Burkina Faso should get in the same ring. And that is called globalization, freedom, liberalization. This is nonsense. This is absolute nonsense. You protect the weak until they become strong before they can compete. Always. This is the rule. This is the rule everywhere. But our leaders, even if we tell them that, they dare not argue. They can't argue. You can't say no. So, one, as you say, one is the weakness, our own weaknesses, the internal weaknesses. And really, until we remove the internal weaknesses, we can't begin. The internal weaknesses are not the only problem. The problem is this pressure from the rich. That we should open up our markets for competition. I'm told we have opened now here for banking, for instance. Banking. Tanzania banking to compete with the European and North American banking.
This is nonsensical.
Can NBC, is NBC free to open a branch in New York? Can NBC really open a branch in New York? So when you are saying, no, let's be treated equal, are you really saying that this equality will give NBC an opportunity to open a branch in New York? Oh. This is rubbish. Absolutely rubbish. So for these big banks, they come to Tanzania, I'm told they're beginning to come. And then they find the NBC. They're complaining.
The NBC is too big, we can't compete for them.
NBC is big for what, Northern Bank? Come back again, NBC.
lazima mtu kurukusa tumelunga matawi yake. Na inawezekana watu wetu wakubali?
So I'm sorry, I've answered your question, but I didn't want to touch that. I did not want to touch that because that's another area where I provoked, I don't stop. So.
Did you like or hate what you heard? Let us know in the comments below.